We are beginning with breaking news. Action News has learned that the Pentagon transit station shooter is from Hollister. He is 36-year-old John Patrick Bedell. And just about 90 minutes ago, the medical examiner's office confirmed that Bedell died at the hospital. He is accused of calmly walking up to two military police officers at the subway entrance, pulling out a gun and shooting them. The officers were hit, but they are expected to be okay. They fired back at Bedell, and less than 2 hours ago, he was confirmed dead. Action News reporter Robbie Kapoor is live outside Bedell's Hollister home with breaking details for us tonight.
Well, Aaron, apparently here in Hollister, that's where 36-year-old John Patrick Bedell spent his formative years. Bedell is a 1991 graduate of San Benito High School, and we're standing out here in a subdevelopment, a gated community where apparently Bedell still has family. Bedell graduated from UC Santa Cruz and also took classes at San Jose State, so he has strong ties to the Central Coast and to the Bay Area. Bedell's someone who apparently went to Washington just recently. We have video from the scene in Washington this evening, where just before 7 p.m. tonight, Bedell allegedly shot two police officers at the subway entrance of the Pentagon before police returned fire with semi-automatic weapons. Now, police are still trying to put together the details of what Bedell's motivation was behind this shooting. In an internet posting obtained by the Associated Press, a user named J. Patrick Bedell wrote he was determined to seek justice for the 1991 death of a Marine here in California. The death was ruled a suicide, but has long been the source of cover-up theories. And the writer said the case would be a step towards revealing the truth behind 9/11. This user also spoke out against marijuana laws. The screen name of the internet poster can be linked to Bedell through documents about a marijuana-related arrest that were posted on the site, which matched the date of the birth of Bedell and official court records that are available online. Now, investigators are still piecing together the motivation behind the shooting. You know, this has gained a lot of national traction here. We have a lot of national and local media here. They're trying to reach out to speak to the family who are not returning phone calls. A radio station out of Los Angeles was able to connect with Bedell's father briefly, confirming the location here in Hollister. But beyond that, we have not heard anything from the family members at this time. One more note we want to mention. Investigators do not believe that Bedell's alleged shooting attempt this afternoon was connected to any kind of terrorist conspiracy. Aaron?
All right, Robbie, thank you. Certainly a confusing time. Thank you, Robbie Kapoor, reporting live for us today. Certainly a confusing time as investigators try to piece together exactly what's going on here, what the motivation was behind tonight's shooting. So we want to go over one more time just exactly what we do know at this point about John Patrick Bedell. He is a 1991 graduate of San Benito High School. He earned a B.S. in physics from UC Santa Cruz. That was in 1994. Did some graduate work at San Jose State after that. His father worked for Bank of America and Hollister for nearly 30 years. We also believe that John Patrick Bedell, who apparently goes by the name Patrick Bedell, also worked as a financial planner in Hollister. And then, of course, 90 minutes ago that we learned that he did die from wounds sustained in today's shooting. And as Robbie sort of alluded to, they are trying to figure out at this point what may have motivated the shooting. And there are some emerging signs that Bedell had some deep-seated resentment of the military and also questioned what really happened with the September 11th attacks. Whether that had anything to do with the shooting at this time, we don't know. But certainly that is something that investigators are going to be looking at very, very closely. Action News has also learned that President Obama is said to be following the case very closely, and the FBI and the Department of Homeland Security are running Bedell's name to see if he has any connection to terror groups. Again, there are emerging signs that Bedell may have harbored some resentment, had some doubts about what happened on September 11th. With more on what it was like inside the transit station tonight, here's Action News reporter Jackie Benson from Virginia.
The gunman walked into what is known as the Pentagon Metro entrance facility about 6:40 p.m. Officials believe he was attempting to enter the Pentagon itself, which requires an ID check.
He walked up very cool, like there was no distress. He had no real emotion in his face. It's very typical for someone to reach for their pass to show it. When he reached in his pocket, they assumed he was going to get a pass, and he came out with a gun.
Witnesses heard as many as a half dozen gunshots as the suspect and at least three officers exchanged gunfire. There were dozens of people in the area. Many got down on the ground, ducking for cover, but no civilians were injured. Two Pentagon police officers were injured. They were rushed to a local hospital.
I am pleased on a number of levels. The officers acted very quickly and decisively to neutralize him as a threat. There was no one else was injured. As you know, at that time of night, you have a lot of people coming and going, so we were fortunate that there was no other injuries.
Investigators say the man was carrying identification and that his ID revealed he had lived in multiple places recently. It's not clear whether the suspect arrived at the Pentagon by Metro.
We have a theory, but it's still a theory. It's going to take time to develop that.
That was Jackie Benson reporting for us tonight. One of the theories that they're looking very closely at tonight is that Bedell did not fully accept what most of us believe happened on September 11th, that there was a terrorist attack from Al-Qaeda that brought down the World Trade Center towers. There are some facts that also coming out about John Patrick Bedell that he had some really deep-seated resentment of the military, which would at least lead some credence to the theory of why he might seek out a military police officer in this shooting. But again, this is all speculation at this point. Investigators are piecing together all of the different facets of this case, from Facebook, from internet postings, from exactly what happened at the scene. But what we do know is that John Patrick Bedell is from Hollister. He's a graduate of San Benito High School. This is a very small town. A lot of people well aware of the Bedells. His father, a prominent person in town, worked for the Bank of America for some 30 years. So as this case develops and as we go through tomorrow and the next few days, we'll get a much clearer idea of perhaps what happened. And certainly a case that is going to affect the small town of Hollister in a very big way. So look for more information on the Pentagon Transit Station shooting and the very latest on the Hollister gunman tomorrow, beginning on Action News Sunrise.